Welkom to Curator Reviews. Well, we were supposed to have a video now on location in the MoCo in Amsterdam. But bloody hell, I got panic attacks. It was so claustrophobic. So I'm happy to be back in my own bar. But okay, I'm going to give a review without video of the location because it was impossible to take videos. MoCo Amsterdam is a museum that is targeting young tourists. They want to offer young tourists something else than the coffee shop or the red light district in Amsterdam. And by that, I think, okay, it is an interesting aim, point of view. They try to attract all these young tourists by bringing basically the highlights of today's art scene. Andy Warhol, Kusama, Hearst, Basquiat, Herring, Banksy, of course. And they don't show art, well, like museum monumental pieces, but pieces from private collections. And, oh, okay, I was interested. MoCo Amsterdam is situated next door to Stedelijk Museum Amsterdam. Well, world-renowned Stedelijk Museum Amsterdam. And MoCo is the neighbor. I went there and because I was interested in what they do to attract the new generation and how to get them involved or enthusiastic about art. And of course, I wanted to make a YouTube movie about that. The building from the outside, it looks beautiful. But as soon as you enter the door, it is claustrophobic. It is so many people are inside. The rooms where they show the art, they are, well, maximum 2 meters by 3 meters. They have canvases of 1.50 meters by 1 meter, but there's only one entrance. So both in and out needs to get the same entrance, and that entrance is 80 centimeters. So there is all the time you are in some kind of, well, you are blocked, you are people, you have to squeeze yourself between the people getting out and you pushing yourself getting in. When you are in, immediately you are stuck again because people are standing still looking at the art, but yeah, what can you basically see? Well, it is 3 stories high, the building, and you all have to use the same stair that is 80 centimeters wide. So going up, going down, the same stairs. So you can imagine how narrow it was, and well, it was a nightmare. I got really panic attacks, feeling claustrophobic. And the only thing I wanted was to get out. The collection on itself, I think it was not that bad. They have the highlight. There's not much narrative. They just show you what is popular now. But what they were showing, they were interesting art pieces. With some art pieces, there's a question about the providence, but okay. I think that for the tourists, it won't bother them. Do people get enthusiastic about art? Because that is what I find, well, important or interesting, how to get the new generation interested in art and see that, well, what is so good about art? And I think, no. In this narrow spaces, you don't have time to observe an artwork. You don't even have the space to really view the art piece. So no, this was not about getting people excited about art. This was just about well, getting the tourist dollar, because they charge a lot, €24 for an entrance ticket. Well, next door at the world-renowned Stedelijk Museum, you pay €17. There you have enough space. You see the same big names and more. And you have all the space in the world you need to really look at an art piece. Yeah, so would I recommend it MoCo? No. The only positive thing about the MoCo was that when I finally could leave the building, I was in their garden, and, well, like the Pope, I was kissing the ground, happy to be out. And then I saw a few statues in their garden, and it felt like heaven. But no. Het MoCo is designed for young tourists, and yeah, they just want to get the money. But there is not a mission to get people involved or enthusiastic about art. So go to the neighbor at Stedelijk Museum.